But it's tea time, dear. It's much too late. It's almost dark, Dot. Why don't you get some grass from the paddock? Rabbits eat any kind of grass.
But Bunny loves the grass from the gully. I'll just go a little way. Oh, Father, please.
Oh, let her go, Jessie.
Truly, I won't be long. Please, Mother, I won't be long.
Oh, all right then.
I'll be careful, I promise. I won't go far. Bye. Hello. What's your name? I'm Dot. I won't hurt you.
Try a bite of this.
For me? To eat? Very nice, thank you.
You poor little thing. You must be starving.
Well, you can talk.
Of course I can talk. All animals can talk. It's just that nobody listens to us.
I always used to listen. I listened to the animals and birds, but I could never understand them.
You can now, if you keep eating these roots. We call it the food of understanding.
Kangaroo!
Oh, I've never seen one like that before.
What funny fur?
Only two legs.
What a funny bird.
Wonder where it lives.
It seems to understand us.
I knew what was the matter with you at once. I feel just the same myself. I've been miserable just like you, ever since I lost my baby Joey. You must have lost something too. Tell me what it is.
I've lost my way.
Ah, I knew you'd lost something. Isn't it a dreadful feeling? And you don't feel like eating anything, even the greenest grass. I've been like that ever since I lost my baby kangaroo. But tell me, what does your way look like? I may be able to find it for you.
It doesn't look like anything, really. I just can't find my home. At night I slept in the bush, and all today I've been walking. I don't know where I am.
Well, isn't that just like a human? You're not fit for this country at all. Of course, if you only have one home in one place, you must lose it. Humans are no good in our bush. Just look at yourself now. How do you compare with a kangaroo? Just look at your fur, all torn. I wonder why you humans are made so badly.
It's only my dress. This tastes very nice.
You mustn't eat any more of that. If you eat too much, you'll know too much.
Can you know too much?
Oh, indeed, yes. And it will make you miserable. I don't want you to be miserable anymore. That's why I'm going to help you find your lost way.
Thank you, Kangaroo. But, could I please have some water? I'm very thirsty.
Of course you are. Everyone's thirsty at sundown. I'm thirsty too. But the nearest waterhole is a long way off. So we'd better start at once. Poor little human. Your legs aren't much good. And I really don't understand how you can expect to get along without a tail.
Oh.
Ah, I have an idea. Just step into my pouch and I'll hop you down to the water hole in no time.
Lovely in here. Thank you.
And I feel as if I had my baby again. Well, we're off.
Some people ride camels and some prefer mules, while others ride turtles and don't they look fools? But I curl up inside just enjoying the view as I ride in the pouch of a red kangaroo.
As she rides in the pouch of a red kangaroo.
We fly through the air and bounce over the ground with a hippity-hoppity-thumpity sound. The best fun in the world, and I tell you it's true, is to ride in the pouch of a red kangaroo.
Is to ride in the pouch of a red kangaroo.
Hippity-hoppity-thumpity-thump. When you come along, you'll know. That's the way we go. You can travel by boat, you can travel by train, you can walk if you like and get stuck in the rain. But the best way to travel, the smart thing to do, is to ride in the pouch of a red kangaroo.
Is to ride in the pouch of a red kangaroo.
Hoppity-hoppity-thump. When you come with us, you'll know. That's the way we go. We jump through the bush and bounce up to the sky. And if you're too frightened, you'd better not try. But just stand aside and shout hullabaloo. There goes Dot in the pouch of a red kangaroo.
Dot in the pouch.
Dot in the pouch.
Dot in the pouch
of a red kangaroo.
That was fun. But how did you...
You must never make any noise near a waterhole.
Oh, I was going to ask, how did you find your way to the water? The bush looks all the same to me.
Look at this rock we're standing on. What do you see?
It's polished like glass. It's so smooth.
smooth with the passing of thousands of kangaroos coming here to drink since time began. All the animals know the bush. It's like a kind of mother to all of us. We'll drink now.
We're so frightened.
We're so frightened.
So thirsty.
Thirsty. So thirsty and so frightened.
Why don't they drink at the waterhole?
Because they're frightened.
Frightened of what?
Humans. But I think it's all right now. Kangaroo, you're so brave. Will you go to the water first and let us know if it's all safe?
We haven't had a drop of water for 2 days, and we're dying of thirst.
Yesterday we waited for hours, and then 2 humans came, and we flew away.
So we're frightened and thirsty.
We love to splash the water with our wings.
Quack, quack. And look for worms and other lovely things.
Quack, quack. But we're much too tired for flying.
And our little beaks are drying.
So all we ever do all day is quack.
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 Quack, 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 quack.
We love to go and paddle in the creek.
Quack, quack. And dibble, dabble, dabble with our feet.
Quack, quack. But we're much too tired for flying.
And our little beaks are drying.
So all we ever do all day is quack.
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 Quack, 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 quack.
We're thirsty and we're frightened, and our throats, they have tightened. We're quivering
and shivering
and waiting till it's dark. We're sobbing
and sighing,
and we almost feel like crying. Oh, there must be something else to do but quack.
Maybe we should be high up in the air.
Quack, quack. And then perhaps we wouldn't have a care.
Quack, quack. But we're much too tired for flying.
And our little beaks are drying.
So all we ever do all day is quack.
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 All we ever do all day. All we ever do all day is quack, 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 quack.
I think you're safe now. You all stay quiet. I'll take a closer look. I think you're safe now. Oh, Anywhere you like, dear.
It's very nice in here.
I prefer to sleep in the open, under the stars. But I thought you might like somewhere warm and dry.
Oh, that's scary.
I wish Mopoke wouldn't make that noise when you're trying to sleep. There's something wrong about some birds who think they're musical. They're so well behaved in the daytime. But as soon as it's night, or a bit of moon in the sky, it's woo-hoo, woo-hoo.
I wish he'd stop.
Mopoke, would you mind singing a little further away? You're upsetting my little friend.
Doesn't she like my song? I think it's beautiful, so sad and mournful. I'm such a great artist. When all the bush is quiet and everyone has time to be miserable, I make them even more miserable. Now, isn't that a nice thing to do?
I'm sure it's lovely, Mopoke, but she is very tired.
I suppose it's not everyone who can appreciate good music.
Oh, oh. Perhaps this is all a dream, and I'll wake up in my bed at home. Do you think I'll ever find my way?
We'll ask the animals for help in the morning. And who knows? The humans might be looking for you at this very moment. Why don't you... Oh.
Frank, we'd never find her now anyway. It's too dark.
I suppose you're right. Just have to get some sleep and start again in the morning. She's been lost for 2 days, Jack.
But Frank, I've been a bushman all my life, and I thought she'd be in the valley here somewhere. But there's no sign of her. So at first light, we'll start searching the water holes.
Yes. It's going to be another cold night. Poor little Dot. I hope she's found some kind of shelter.
What's the matter?
I was dreaming about my father. I dreamt he was standing there calling me, calling Cooey.
You're tired. You must rest. Try to sleep now.
I wouldn't move if I were you, my friend. Good morning. Lovely day today. Might rain later, though. You can't tell anymore. The weather's gone all funny. I suppose you're wondering where your friend is. She's gone to get you some breakfast. That's where she's gone. And to arrange a council of the animals for you. Ask me to keep an eye on you. Lucky, wasn't it? She's a lovely lady, isn't she? What was I saying? Oh, yes. Don't move. Nasty fellas, these snakes. Never had any time for snakes. They're not gentlemen, you know. It's not good manners to go round biting people. I'd never dream of biting anyone. Except snakes, of course.
Well, what will I do?
Nothing. Just relax and enjoy yourself. There's nothing at all to worry about if you don't move. He'll come out into the sun soon, you'll see. And then... Ah, there. You see? Goodness gracious, just look at those fangs. Quite the largest fangs I've ever seen. Keep still now. Remember what I said?
you are.
Come, Dot, we must go.
Are we going home?
No.
Where are we going then?
We're going to the Council of the Animals.
Council of the Animals? What's that?
It's when the animals come together to decide important matters. Matters like how to find your lost way.
Can they really help me find my way home?
I hope so. Animals are very clever, you know. We should get to the billabong by evening. That's where we meet.
Some people ride camels and some prefer mules, while others ride turtles and don't they look fools? But I curl up inside just enjoying the view as I ride in the pouch of a red kangaroo.
As she rides in the pouch of a red kangaroo.
We fly through the air and bounce over the ground with a hippity-hoppity-floppity-sound. The best fun in the world, and I tell you it's true, is to ride in the pouch of a red kangaroo.
Is to ride in the pouch of a red kangaroo.
Hoppity-hoppity-floppity-flop. When you come with us, you'll know. Hoppity-hoppity-floppity-flop. That's the way we go.
You can travel by boat, you can travel by train, you can walk if you like and get soaked in the rain. But the best way to travel, the smart thing to do, is to ride in the pouch of a red kangaroo.
Is to ride in the pouch of a red kangaroo. Dot in the pouch,
Dot in the pouch,
Dot in the pouch
of a red kangaroo.
We can live in the water
and drink when we oughta.
Oh, what fun you have when you're a frog.
A frog
on a log.
A log
when you're a frog.
A frog
when we see a man with a gun, and everyone else starts to run.
We dive in the twink
as quick as a wink.
Oh, what fun you have when you're a frog.
A frog
on a log.
A log
when you're a frog.
A frog.
Now that's a log. This is a frog.
Now I'm sure you will agree, we're as handsome as can be.
And we look so sweet with our little webbed feet.
Hi, diddle dee dee. Bet you can't catch me.
When a fisherman tries to catch us, all the fish make such a fuss and fuss. We just hop 1, 2, 3.
And we're up a tree.
Oh, what fun you have when you're a frog.
A frog.
On a log.
A log.
When you're a frog.
A frog.
No, that's a log. This is a frog.
Now I'm sure you will agree, we're as handsome as can be.
And we look so sweet with our little webbed feet.
Hi, diddle dee. Bet you can't catch me.
I'm a frog,
I'm a frog,
I'm a frog,
I'm a frog. We can live in a tree,
or a log,
or a log.
We can hop like a room,
and be a master too.
Oh, what fun you have when you're a frog.
That's not a log, and that's not a frog.
Now won't you come with me, you'll be happy as can be, and join in the fun of being a frog.
A frog,
and a log, with a frog.
A frog.
Ribbit.
Hello. Coming to the meeting, are you? You're a little early.
We're going to the meeting after our evening dance.
Would you care to join us? We're practicing something new.
Can we stay? Please. I love dancing.
Yes, of course. But I'm not very fond of dancing, so I'll just watch. But remember, we mustn't be late for the meeting. the meeting. Here we are, the Council of the Animals. They're going to help you find your lost way. They're very clever. They always know what to do when there's trouble in the bush. You probably all heard about her by now. She's trying to find her way, and she needs your help.
But she's human. What have humans ever done for us?
That's true. If she's lost, it's her own fault. Animals don't get lost.
Of course they do. You all know my child, don't you? My Joey? Where is he?
That's right. He's lost.
Poor kangaroo.
She's so brave.
What a shame.
Poor lost baby.
He's lost. Some humans came to hunt in the bush. They chased me, and I hid Joey in some bushes to keep him safe. Then I led the hunters away, and when I returned, my Joey was gone.
How terrible for her.
Betsy, not knowing.
Dear little mind.
I've searched for days. I can't find him. So you see, my child is lost, too. Just like this human child here.
I wonder what happened.
We should have helped.
We really should help.
Poor little human.
Kangaroo, so kind.
Well, we should be kind, too.
Now, will you help?
Yes, let's help. Of course we will.
She's a dear little thing.
We'll help, huh?
Yes. We'll help, Dot.
I'd like to help, but I don't know where your home is.
And neither do I.
I don't go near humans.
I've never even seen one.
You're lucky.
I don't know where they live, do you?
No, so we really can't help.
Poor little Dot.
Sorry. We can't help you.
Do. Oh, please.
Just a moment. I said we can't help you, but we know who can. You must go to the wisest animal in the bush, the platypus.
Of course.
The platypus. He's very wise.
He knows everything.
Yes, the platypus.
Go to the platypus.
The platypus.
That's really the best advice we can give, Kangaroo. And now we must close the meeting. Goodbye, Dot. And good luck.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye,
Dot. Goodbye,
Dot. Hurry. This way.
Thank you.
Where are we?
It's a sacred cave. But nobody ever comes here anymore.
Why not?
Because they were afraid of the bunyip.
The bunyip?
Yes. There were people living here many years ago, all around this cave. And they had a camp just outside, where the animals have their meetings. There it is.
What happened?
One evening, the men in the tribe went fishing down in the billabong. They heard a strange roaring noise coming from the water. And out of the middle of the billabong came a monster, as big as 20 men.
That was the bunyip?
Yes, with a long neck and sharp claws and covered with hair.
Years old. So you better come home quickly, and you better hide very soon, or the bunyip's going to get you in the bunyip's partly animal, the bunyip's partly bird. The bunyip makes the strangest sound that you have ever heard. So you better come home quickly. And the bunyip's very mean. He's the most unpleasant monster that you have ever seen. So you better come home quickly, and you better hide very soon, or the bunyip's going to get you.
And the people were so frightened that they all ran away and never came back again.
My mother and father must be so worried about me.
We'll go and see Platypus in the morning. All the animals say he knows everything. I'm sure he'll be able to help us find your way.
Ask me, a little kid doesn't stand much of a chance out here. It's bad country.
Hmm? What? Oh. Yes. But we'll keep going. We must keep on searching.
Can't understand it. We followed her trail, plain as day, right up to the top of that ridge. And then those animal tracks everywhere, and Dot's tracks stop. Not another sign. As if she just vanished.
Yes, I know. If we find her at all, it'll be a miracle.
Are you sure Platypus lives here?
Yes.
Why doesn't he come? Perhaps he doesn't know we're here.
He knows all right. He knows everything. He just won't be hurried, that's all. He'll talk to us when he's good and ready. Here he is. Look, that's Mrs. Platypus with him. Remember to be very polite to him. Though it's very hard to be polite to Platypus because you don't know how to behave towards him. If you treat him as an animal, you offend his bird qualities. If you treat him as a bird, you offend his animal qualities. It's so difficult talking to two creatures in one.
Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Dot.
I'm Ornithorhynchus Paradoxus. Now tell me, little human, are you going to write a book about me? Because if you are, I'll leave immediately. I can't stand any more books being written about me.
I couldn't write a book.
You're quite sure? I can't stand humans who write books about me.
Quite sure.
Then I'll try to believe you. But it's difficult to believe human beings. They tell such dreadful stories. One human said, I was a duck. A duck, mind you. Another said I was a rat or a mole and other such nonsense.
And a third said that I don't lay eggs at all and that we were beavers in disguise.
Such insults. And us too. When our ancestors were on Earth millions of years before you humans were ever thought of.
A million years is a very long time.
I didn't say a million. I said millions. My ancestors were the famous Amphitherium, the illustrious Phaxolotherium, and the renowned Stereognathus. So there.
I didn't know that.
Of course you didn't. That's because humans are so new. When you've been around for a few million years more, like us old respected families, you won't be quite so ignorant. Now, what is it you want?
I'm trying to find my way.
I don't know.
Oh, but Kangaroo said you knew everything.
That's true. I know that I don't know where you live. But wait, what sort of bush creatures come around your burrow?
I don't live in a burrow. I live in a house.
How frightfully uncomfortable for you.
I like it. And the bush creatures like it too. Because they visit us all the time. Crickets and grasshoppers, mice, lizards, swallows and possums, and flying foxes. Kookaburras too. And magpies and willy wagtails.
Stop! That last one is the answer. Find Willy Wagtail. He'll lead you straight home. He lives on the other side of Echo Mountain. You'll get there by nightfall if you hurry.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Platypus. Sorry. I meant, Paradoxus?
Ornithorhynchus Paradoxus, if you please.
She seems to be a pleasant child, just a trifle lacking in education. Shall we inform her, my dear?
Yes. Let's.
I'm an Ornithorhynchus Paradoxus. And when you see me first, you're in but like the shoxus. I have a tail just like a beaver, and fur just like a bear, with feet just like a otter. Don't you know it's rude to stare? I'm really quite superior, and I trust that you're aware. I'm an Ornithorhynchus Paradoxus.
He's an Ornithorhynchus Paradoxus.
I just said that.
I beg your pardon.
What's the matter with you? Your turn now.
Thank you. I am an ornithorhynchus paradoxus.
Good.
And when you see me first, you're in the quite a shock zone.
Oh.
I give milk like any cow, and lay eggs like any bird. If you didn't know me better, you'd say it's quite absurd. So at the risk of being monotonous, and in case you haven't heard...
What?
I'm an ornithorhynchus paradoxus.
You heard what she said. She's an ornithorhynchus paradoxus.
It's togetherness time now, my dear.
About time.
Are you ready?
What?
We are ornithorhynchus paradoxus. And when you see us first, you're in the quite a shocksus. It's really quite extraordinary. You won't believe your ears. We've been living in Australia now for 60 million years. We're a well-established family. So give three hearty cheers.
Hip hooray, hip hooray, hip hooray, hip hooray.
For the ornithorhynchus paradoxus. The ornithorhynchus.
The ornithorhynchus.
The ornithorhynchus paradoxus.
There now.
It's my mummy. Do you think we'll ever find Willy Wagtail?
I think so. He's a very small bird, but he's always singing. We'll hear quite well from a long way off. He's very friendly, too. I'm sure he'll help us find your way.
You can't get a good day's sleep anymore. Talk, talk, talk. Hello, kangaroo. Hello. What are you?
I'm a girl.
Oh, I've never heard of a girl before, or seen one either. What sort of tree do you live in?
I live at home. That is, when I'm there.
Then where are you now?
I'm not at home.
Oh, then you live where you don't live. Where's that?
I've lost it, and I don't know where it is.
Oh, you make my head feel empty. I don't understand you at all. I live in this gum tree. Would you like some of my gum leaves? They're delicious.
No, thank you. Mm. When I'm at home, I have milk and bread and eggs and lettuce and...
I've never ever heard of those. I'd love to see the trees they grow on. Will you show an egg tree or a bread tree to me?
They don't grow on trees. Oh, you don't understand.
Now you've made my head feel empty again. I think I'll have a little sleep. That'll make me feel better. Good night.
Wait. Can you tell us how to find Willy Wagtail?
Huh? Willy Wagtail? Oh, yes. Over there. On the other side of Echo Mountain.
Do you know the best way over the mountain? At least we're going in the right direction. It's too far away.
It's very strange.
Yes. I'll have to go a little further on and sniff the air and listen carefully. I won't go far, so don't be afraid. Just stay here quietly till I come back.
Hurry! 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 Hurry!
Running away.
There's something wrong. Some kind of danger up ahead.
Danger! Danger! Danger!
Wombat, wait!
Danger! Danger! Oh, it's humans! All the animals are leaving! Danger! Danger!
We can't turn back now. We'll have to keep going, that's all. But we must be careful. They're holding a corroboree. We should go now.
Oh, look! Can we stay a little longer, please? I've never seen a corroboree before. They're dancing. You know I love dancing.
All right, but not too long. See those dingoes down there? If they find out I'm here, they'll attack. Sort of dance, that one. Oh, it's horrible. I can't bear to look.
We'll go then if you like. Oh! What are they doing now? They're going to kill him.
They must have seen me. In my pouch. Quickly.
But if you carry me, you'll never get away.
Come on. There's no time. Hurry.
You must put me down. You'll be killed.
No. No, never again. I'll never leave a child alone again. I'm going to jump. Dingoes won't give up. I can hear them. They're crossing the gully now.
The dingoes! They're coming!
Is that so now? We'll have to do something about that, won't we?
But how can you? You're such little birds.
We bitterns may be little birds, but we have
very big voices.
You can't go on. You're sick. You need a doctor. Another day out here and you'll be dead. That wouldn't do anyone any good. Not Jessie, not the child.
You're right.
I've never seen you sick like this before. We'll head for home right now.
I don't know how I'm going to tell Jessie.
Must be thirsty. Give her some water.
Water? I'll have to go way down to the river. There's no water here.
Of course there is. It's all around you. There. Scrape away that moss. Dear me. You humans are so helpless.
Oh, there's water here.
Of course there is. Now, give Kangaroo a drink. That's fine. Now pick some of those herbs and give them to her. There. Keep looking after her and she'll be all right. You'll soon be on your way again.
And so must we. Take care. Thank you.
Thank you.
where we are. The far side of Echo Mountain.
But where's Willy Wagtail?
That's him. He's always singing. Look.
Clickety-click, clickety-click. Willy Wagtail keeps singing that clickety-click. All the bush birds agree, my best trickety-trick is my clickety-clickety-click. Clickety-click, 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 clickety-click. It's up in the morning and clickety-click, click-click when I pounce on a worm. Pretty quickety-quick, I sing clickety, clickety, clickety,
click-click. Frogs croak,
ribbit, ribbit.
Ducks quack,
quack, quack.
And kookaburras, ha, ha, ha. Snakes hiss, seagulls wail. And no one makes a sound like little Willy Wagtail.
Clickety-click, clickety-click. All the day long I sing clickety-click. And I'm certain that I won't get sickety-sick of saying clickety, clickety-click.
Dogs croak,
ribbit, ribbit.
Ducks quack,
quack, quack.
And kookaburras, ha, ha, ha. Snakes hiss, dingoes wail. But no one makes a sound, that funny little sound,
clickety-click,
like Willy Wagtail.
Clickety-click,
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 clickety-click.
All the day long I sing clickety-click. And I'm certain that I won't get sickety-sick of saying clickety,
clickety-click,
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 clickety-click, clickety-click, clickety-click, clickety-click, clickety-click. Just one more time, folks. Clickety,
clickety, clickety, clickety, clickety. Doesn't he know who you are?
Everyone knows me. I'm Willy Wagtail.
My little friend here is lost. Platypus said you might be able to help us find her home.
A little human. I like humans. They're friendly to me, so I'm friendly to them. What's your name?
Dot.
Dot? That's a pretty name. And isn't that strange? I heard someone calling your name just the other day.
Oh, they were looking for me? Where are they?
They're gone by now. But I know where they live. In a house with big verandas.
And a garden with roses and a wooden fence and...
Not so fast. That's the one.
But how do we get there?
Oh, that's easy. Just follow the trail west. It goes past the bottom of the hill there. I'll take you home. Follow me.
We searched everywhere. She's just gone. There's nothing else we can do.
Clickety-click, clickety-click. Willy Wagtail keeps singing that clickety-click. All the bush birds agree, my best trickety-trick is my clickety-click.
Clickety-click,
clickety-click, clickety-click, clickety-click.
It's up in the morning and clickety-click, click-click when I pounce on a worm. Pretty quickety-quick, I sing clickety,
clickety,
click, clickety, click, clickety, click,
clickety, click.
All the day long I sing clickety, click, and I'm certain that I won't get sickety, sick of saying clickety,
clickety,
click, clickety, 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 click. Just one more time, folks. Clickety,
clickety,
clickety, click.
No, I can't come with you.
Why not?
Because these are your people, your family.
Oh, please, please come with me.
No, this is your home. My home is out there.
But you'll wait for me, won't you? I'll bring my mother and father to you here, just here. I won't be long.
Look! It's impossible. It's Dot. 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 You're safe. What happened? Where were you?
Are you all right?
Yes, Daddy, yes.
Oh, my baby. Dot, darling, what happened to you? We thought that you were...
You were... I was lost, and I didn't know what to do. And the kangaroo gave me food to eat and took me to see all the animals. And I talked to them and...
Wait. Wait, dear. You're too quick for me. You did say a kangaroo.
Yes. Yes, a kangaroo. She's waiting for me. There, behind that bush. Come on. I'll show you. Hurry. She's not here. She's gone. Where are you? Come back. Come back. Come back.
Dot. Dot, please don't be sad. Your kangaroo must have her freedom. Must live her own life. She's going home. And her home is the bush. Kangaroo must have her freedom. Freedom, 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 freedom.